So HHN 2018, let's talk about it. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? How you guys doing today? I am the Knights of Anthony, and today we're going to talk about HHN 2018, give you my review of the event and what I thought about each and every maze, scare zones, terror tram, sadly the Jabberwockies, but we're going to talk about it. Also, shout out to Horror Knights for the passcode of the night for the purge. Got this awesome purge hat for free. That's awesome of them. But without further ado, let's just get this video started. We're going to start by ranking the mazes first, because I didn't actually write down the scare zones or anything from the event, but I already kind of have them in my head of what was good and what wasn't. So, well, for that, let's just start this by now. The scare zones I thought were all fantastic. I didn't think one of them sucked at all, so that's good. Let's talk about the mazes. We're going to start off with number 9, which is going to be The Walking Dead, of course. Do I have to say anymore? I'm just going to leave it at that. Walking Dead number 9, all your attraction. Couple more zombies, no big deal. Number 8 is gonna go to the first purge. Now, the first purge, don't get me wrong, wasn't completely terrible. Now, the first purge exceeded my expectations way more than I thought. There was a lot of scenes that I saw from the movie that were pretty cool to see come to life. A couple of black walls, but I could see with the movie like The Purge how that happened, because like I said, I don't think this movie was meant for a maze, and I thought this. I thought that The Purge in general was always a great concept for a scare zone. So, for them to bring it to life as a maze was a risky move, but nonetheless, they did a really good job inside the maze, other than the fact of the black walls. But, like I said, Purge has always just been made for a scare zone, and yeah, guys, I'd much rather see it as a scare zone than a freaking maze. Number 7 is going to go to the Horrors of Blumhouse Chapter 2. This is another maze that really exceeded my expectations as well, because I didn't know how they were going to bring these two properties to life. By the properties, I mean Truth or Dare and Unfriended. Now, Truth or Dare did have a scene in the maze that's not in the movie, and Murdy said that was going to happen, which was the scene, if you saw in the maze walkthrough, where we see the nun brutally murder some people, and she's got the smile on her face like from the demon. That was not in the film, as I recall, but the church was a major part in the film, and so that was pretty cool. The masks were okay. I kind of was expecting that they were going to sculpt them like that, but nonetheless, they looked really cool. And then when you go to the Unfriended part, it was kind of hard to translate that into a maze too, because a lot of the movie, or not a lot of it, all of the movie, except for the very end, is taking place on a Skype chat, and it's all filmed through a computer. So, for them to bring a lot of the kills to life was interesting, because you got to see them in a new point of view, a new perspective, and you got to see way more of the demon that you see for the very last second of the movie at the end. So that was interesting to see. However, the thing that saved this maze for me was the very end, because it was an original ending based off the intro of Blumhouse. If you guys are not familiar, it was the little girl and the room going all crazy and stuff like that, because it's a paranormal entity. And that was just really cool. They made the girl really look sinister and stuff like that. When you turn the corner and go down the hallway, you see the devil that's kind of possessing her and stuff like that. But nonetheless, they made her look really sinister, and I thought that was really cool. But that's what kind of saved the maze for me. A lot of black walls in here, but I can see why, because there isn't a lot of content to work with for this movie, and what they did with the content that they had available to work with, they did an amazing job with it. But I think what saved this maze for me the most was the ending of the maze with the original ending. Number 6 is going to go to Halloween 4. Now, Halloween 4 was honestly better than the movie. I'm not really a big fan of Halloween 4 because, honestly, the concept for me for that movie was okay. It wasn't like the best Halloween movie, but it was a Halloween movie nonetheless. But they got a lot of the major parts in the movie to life, which was cool, and they didn't use the stupid mask like they did in the movie. They used the actual good mask from like the first one and the second one and stuff like that. But nonetheless, Halloween 4 had an amazing facade, had an amazing, they brought a lot of the scenes to life, a couple black walls, but that didn't stop me. I looked at it as transitions to a different scene. Wasn't too bad though. A lot of good scares in there, a lot of iconic scenes brought to life, and that was cool. Number five for me is gonna go to Poltergeist. Now the facade for this was awesome, especially a lot of the flashing and all that. And this was another maze that had a lot of black walls, but I gave it a pass for this one because this, much like The Exorcist and The Shining, is a lot to, it, there wasn't a lot to work with. It's a slow start, and then it jumps up in like towards the end, middle-ish. But the scenes they did bring to life were awesome. They had the giant skull come at you twice. They had the giant like skull with the body, skinny body, come at you. That was pretty cool. The clown was represented. They had the tree. The opening of the maze was the little girl holding onto the TV, talking to the people on the other side. They had a lot of the iconic scenes. The steak moving on its own, you know, in the kitchen. All the chairs stacked and everything. It was just a really cool scene. Nonetheless, it was really fun to go through, and I really enjoyed this maze. Number four is going to be going to the Terror Tram, Hollywood Harry's Dread Time Stories. I really enjoyed the Terror Tram this year because this year they brought back Hollywood Harry, and honestly, they gave him a speaking role this time, so they put more of a personality, more of a sinister vibe to this character, which I really much enjoyed, and I hope he comes back for the future for maybe a third year or to run the entire event as an icon, because over in Hollywood we've been wanting an icon for a while, and I think Hollywood Harry would fit that. I think he would fit that position perfectly, especially what we just saw this year at the Terror Tram. His story was he took two of the tram hosts and he hold them for ransom, and you're supposed to go through his dread time stories where they had dogs with chainsaws coming at you, a cannibal motel, which was really cool. Then you go up to the, before the plane crash area, there's the scarecrows that you have to go through and stuff. They want to try to kill you. Then as you go to the plane crash area, it's all clowns. And at the very end, you go to an asylum, which was really cool, and it's stuff like that. He described it as, of course, dreams can come to life, but also nightmares can come to life too. So it was very fun. And Hollywood Harry was around the whole thing, and I just really much enjoyed this Terror Tram this year. Number three is gonna go to Trick or Treat. Trick or Treat exceeded my expectations well more than I expected because they got a lot of the iconic scenes to life, which was really cool. Each part of the movie in chronological order. In the beginning, when you walk in, you see, of course, the lady who gets killed and hung up in the sheets. That was really cool to see. Then you go to the principal's house, and then you see all that kind of stuff, which was really cool. Then you go to the werewolf scene, which was really cool to see the wolves come to life and stuff like that. Of course, you see the children in the quarry, which they really did an amazing job in the quarry scene. I thought that was phenomenal. It was a huge set and it was awesome. Thought it came out amazing. Then after that, you see another facade and you go into the bus driver's house, which was really cool, really awesome. Then you see Sam everywhere. You see a lot of the iconic scenes come to life. It was just really cool, and I really, really enjoyed it. I'm going back two more times this year, and I cannot wait to go back into it. Number two is gonna go to Stranger Things. Now, this and Universal Monsters were neck and neck. These two properties this year probably killed the entire event because these two properties were honestly the best thing of this event this year. Stranger Things Season 1, it brought a lot of the infamous scenes to life. The Demogorgon looked freaking awesome. One of my favorite parts of the maze is when you go through and you see the light scene where the mom puts up with the lights. She kind of makes her own like little Ouija board to talk with Will. That was an awesome scene to go through. You go through Hawkins' laboratory, which was really fucking cool to see. You see a lot of the iconic scenes with the Demogorgon and stuff like that. You go in the Upside Down and it was cold. They really outdid themselves with this maze, and I hope they bring it back for Season 2 for next year because that was just such a badass maze. Another awesome part is when you see Eleven in the classroom holding down the Demogorgon. That was so fucking badass. I'm glad they really incorporated at least one of the kids. They didn't incorporate any of the kids in this maze, but you do hear their voices and dialogue throughout the entire maze, so that was really cool of them to do. And of course, the last maze that I really enjoyed this year at the event was Universal Monsters, because I got hyped up at Scare LA when they shared a lot of information about it, and going through it, it exceeded my expectations, and seeing a lot of the iconic monsters and stuff like that after the maze was finished, going into Monsters Masquerade and stuff like that, all awesome. concept that they brought us together with. They made the monsters look so badass. It looks really scary and stuff like that. You go to different movies and stuff and different iconic scenes from the movies and stuff like that. Probably one of two favorite scenes I had in that entire maze was the Invisible Man. He looked really cool, and I like the neon lights they put on him to make him look invisible and stuff like that. That was really cool. And I would have to say the second favorite part of the entire maze was the Bride of Frankenstein room, where you see Dr. Frankenstein working on the Bride of Frankenstein, and then you see Frankenstein's monster hit the switch and kill us all. That was awesome. The scare zone was awesome too. And that's gonna bring us to our scare zone portion of the video, where we're gonna talk about each scare zone and how they were and stuff like that. Hell's Harvest, awesome. I love the whole idea of the killer dolls coming at you with chainsaws and stuff like that. They also had like this little ventriloquist booth where they had two skeletons talking to you and stuff, and they were really funny. Trick or Treat was really awesome. Seeing a lot of the werewolf ladies transforming and already transformed was really cool. Seeing the bus of kids there, the rules, the iconic sheets and stuff like that, it was really cool and it was really awesome. Monsters Masquerade was phenomenal. The ending to the maze of Universal Monsters and then tying into that right when you walk out was really cool, really fun, and I really enjoyed it. Toxic Tunnel this year was really good. The actors really did a good job, and I really appreciate all the hard work they do. After watching the League's podcast about working in Toxic Tunnel, like, I viewed it different this year, and I really thought it was really good. They really did a great job in there, so thanks Scare Actors for that, and that was awesome. Thanks actually Scare Actors for the entire event. You guys did a phenomenal job. And the last one, Holidays in Hell, was fucking awesome. Each holiday was represented, and I really enjoyed walking through each holiday. A lot of the iconic figures of that holiday were brought to life in a more sinister way, and I really, really enjoyed it, so that was cool. And of course, there was the Jabberwockies, where this year they were trying to connect back to the Wi-Fi. It was called Jabberwockies Presents Connected. It was okay. I mean, I kind of just sat in there because of the air conditioning, and they were somewhere to sit down, but it was okay. Me and my cousin, we don't care too much about it, but it is what it is. So that is my review of the event. If I have to rate this event out of 10, it's gonna get a solid 7.5 out of 10, because it was a great event, a phenomenal event. There was just a couple mazes that I didn't like. Of course, I wouldn't say completely liked, but like, I didn't like some parts of the mazes and stuff like that. And then Jabberwockies wasn't, you know, I'm not a big fan of Jabberwockies, but still, my all-time favorite year is gonna go to 2016. So thank you guys for watching this HHN 2018 review. I will see you guys. I will be there two more times out of the year, October 14th and November 3rd. If you guys catch me, come say hi, come take a picture, come say hello, walk through a maze with me. It'll be fun. Make sure to follow me on social media at Knights of Horror on Twitter and at the Knights of Horror on Instagram. Make sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification to be part of the Madhouse and become a knight. And I just hit 200 subscribers, and I want to thank each and every one of you in the Madhouse for that, and I am very appreciative for that. And I have something big coming tomorrow. Make sure to tune into the channel to find out what that is, if you want to be a part of that, and if you want to try to be, yeah, pretty much part of it in a way. So thanks guys for watching. I will see you guys in the next one, and bye.